In this video, we look into the saying, good employees leave bad managers, and we get behind the truth of it. Have you ever heard the expression, good employees leave bad managers, not the job? In my experience, sayings like these are around for a reason. And that one simple reason is there's usually truth behind it. So in this video, right after you subscribe, we're going over six reasons good employees leave bad managers. And that's aside from a manager just being a dick. Reason number one, they overwork people. The good employees, the ones who put everything into their job, they know when somebody's taking advantage of their work habits. Just because someone excels at their job and they can complete it efficiently, it doesn't give you the right to just pile more work on, trying to get them to the breaking point. And if you feel that you need to add more work to them, well, you better be adding a little bit more cash to their paycheck. You need to be adding a title to their name or some other promotion, bonus, or something with perceived value to them. Number two, managers don't recognize the good work. Whether expressed or not, everyone likes some sort of recognition for a job well done. Of course, monetary, ching ching, it's usually the first thing on people's minds, but that doesn't have to be the case. Depending on the scope of the project, it could be as simple as walking up and just showing appreciation, saying thank you. Thanks for a job well done, really appreciate it. Or it could be acknowledgement in front of their peers, or a small gift, or a bonus. The worst thing a manager can do is not acknowledge a job well done because, well, it's the person's job. That's what I pay them for anyway. Trust me, this response does not help anybody. Reason number three, they just don't give a shit about their employees. They look at their employees as a piece of equipment, a piece of machinery. They don't show concern, they don't show empathy, they don't even look at their employee as human, let alone equals. The moment that this becomes your default attitude is the moment you've lost your staff. Now here's a pro tip. I understand that you can't like everybody. It's not possible, it's not natural, and it's not normal. But try to look at them as if they were family or as if they were a close friend. How would you be treating a close friend? Honest. You want to try to spark some kind of feeling towards these people. Like I said, you don't have to like everybody, but just try to give them that respect, that somebody does like them. The number four reason, manager that does not keep their word. As a manager, you must do everything to protect your word and to protect your honor. With your word and with your honor, that's how you get employees to really do stuff for you, because they respect you and they trust you. If you say that it's gonna benefit because of such and such, then you had better be able to show that benefit and not have it be lip service. Those that cannot keep their word will soon lose their respect, and very shortly after that, they lose their employees. Number five, they hire or they promote the wrong people. Now, this one kind of, it hits close to home. It stings a little bit. Good employees want to see good employees getting promoted. They want to work with people that are like themselves. When they see poor workers get promoted, they might take it as an insult, and they'll tend to lose motivation for getting the job done. Yeah, sure, you could hire a guy that knows a guy because he knew a guy, but sooner or later, your team is gonna fall apart. They're all gonna start walking to the door, or they'll just totally be disheartened and disinterested in the work, and they're just gonna go through the motions. Number six, they don't help develop people. Good managers look for ways that they can help employees grow. This could be by helping them develop skills, by training them. It could be something like, you know that your employee loves cooking, you've got a somewhat celebrity chef friend, you introduce them. Now yeah, of course, that example could be anything, but what I'm trying to say is that you want to take an active role in the work relationship. And part of that is helping employees develop further in skills and life. Now, of course, there's a ton more reasons that good people are going to leave bad managers. And if you have some examples that you'd like to share, please leave a comment below. And while you're there, subscribe, give us a thumbs up. I'll see you on the next one.